What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's your boy Joe, and I'm back at you with another video. So this past Sunday, we had two amazing playoff games. They were both instantly top 10. But as you can see from the title of this video, we're not going to be talking about the Jacksonville game quite yet. We're going to be talking about the Vikings and Saints game, more specifically the last play. I'm going to break it down for you and explain to you what happened and why Marcus Williams couldn't just tackle him. So really quickly, here's the clip of the last play of the game. Okay, so as you can see there, he made a 61-yard touchdown pass. He completed it. They were on their own 39. They needed to get to the other 39 to at least get in somewhat of field goal range to win the game. They would have won it by 1 point. And so, yeah, they needed to get to their own 39. Stefon Diggs made an amazing, amazing play. He caught it at their own he caught it at the Saints 34-yard line. He realized no one was around him, so he's like, heck, I'll just run it in and make a touchdown. But let's break it down. Why couldn't Marcus Williams just tackle? Marcus Williams is number 43. He was playing what we called it whenever I played football. We called it a shadow safety. He basically was just back there. They were guarding the line, the out of bounds lines, and they were trying to keep everyone in. And so what happened? Why couldn't he tackle him? Well, number one, he jumped it a little early. If you look back, you can see that he ran at him. He jumped it just a tad early, and he couldn't quite get there. The second reason is because he wasn't looking at him. If you notice, when he goes in with his head down. When I played football, we were always told when you tackle, keep your head slightly up, not completely up, because if you get hit in your head, you're going to break your neck. Keep it slightly up to where you can still see. Don't ever drop your head low to where you're looking at the ground when you tackle. Okay? That's how we were taught. We were also taught to go in with a shoulder, hit him in the torso area, not really the legs, because the legs can get out. And if you grab on the torso, they can't really get out of you. The second reason is he pulled off of the tackle because if he had hit him when he was still in the air, he would have been marked as a defenseless player. So he pulled off to not get called a foul. Had he jumped it a little later, I feel like Stefon Diggs would have gotten away from him. So he did the right thing, but he didn't do the right thing. And so what that caused him to do is he didn't really have a choice. He had to go when he did. He could have gone for the ball, but I still think Stefon Diggs would have still made it in for the touchdown. And so with that being said, he jumped it a little early. He wasn't looking at him. And if he had hit him, it would have been a penalty because he would have been a defenseless player because he was still in the air. Okay, so what else happened in that play? When Marcus Williams went for him, he hit the guy behind him, causing it to make it to where Stefon Diggs was all by himself, all alone. No one was around him, and the only other person who could have made a play on that one was the safety on the other end of the field. So anyway, guys, that's my breakdown for the day. Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like if you guys like. If you guys agree with me or disagree with me, let me know down in the comment section. And most of all, guys, don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. God bless you. Peace.